What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Jacob here at the Nutrition Store, and yeah, it's time for another TNS Takedown. Today we bring you a video from a company called BlueStar Nutraceuticals. They have been known throughout history to make some crazy, outlandish claims about their test boosters and all kinds of products that simply don't do what they claim. Most of their videos are actually taken down or removed due to, inaccuracy. Got a little jewel for you guys. Let's check it out.
Cardio makes you fat. Gotcha.
Cardio makes you fat. Got me.
However, the truth is there is some scientific evidence that shows excessive cardio increases cortisol production.
Yes, cortisol, the primary hormone responsible from stress induction. Now, stress doesn't always mean stress as in you can't pay the bills. Stress could be working out, not getting adequate sleep, any kind of stressor that can occur throughout the daily.
And in turn, decreases norepinephrine production, making burning fat and keeping it off a lot harder than it needs to be.
Cortisol is increased, norepinephrine does decrease, but don't let this statement fool you. Norepinephrine is not the primary driver of fat reduction.
Nor what? Thought you might say that. Norepinephrine is the master male fat burning hormone. It's the direct activator of fat metabolism.
Okay, it's not the master male fat burning hormone. There's also other hormones such as insulin, glucagon, epinephrine itself, two other brain functioning hormones. I don't remember the names. Guys and girls, long story short here, epinephrine is not the sole driver of lipolysis or the breakdown of fat cells. This is extremely nitpicking a situation and isn't completely true.
It breaks down fat and preserves lean muscle. If you've been struggling to burn fat and get six-pack abs, even though you've been working out regularly, you may now know why.
Okay, well, why might be that you're not consuming less calories than you burn. And guys, I sound like a broken record here, but a lot of these advertisements, they nitpick physiology on such a small level that it makes you think that these little factors are more important than the overarching concept, which is calories in, calories out. Now, you can argue with me all day with that, but at the end of the day, thermodynamics don't lie. And if you're not tracking your calories and you want to come and argue about this, well, there's a reason that you haven't achieved your goals because you're nitpicking the little details like they do here.
Luckily for you, as an international cover model who has graced the cover of 30 plus magazines.
Okay, dude, this is what we call an appeal to authority or an argument from authority. Now, in classic debate, this is a statement whereby, hey, look at my title, therefore listen to me. This is all fine and good in standard conversation if it's just me and you chatting, but if we're talking about factual information, relying on your title is not evidence. Repeatable evidence is evidence.
I've been able to determine the three most effective strategies to crank up norepinephrine levels and fat burning for men, allowing you to burn fat 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, regardless of extra effort or exercise.
24/7 fat burning? Not possible. You would die. You would wither away and die. Also, here's your three simple effective steps. Burn more calories than you eat, exercise hard, weight train frequently, and follow a structured regimen. Well, that's four. Dang it.
So stop doing excessive cardio and click the link in the video right now to watch my free video presentation while you still can.
Why should I watch it, dude? Because you're a fitness model or because you're going to try to sell me something? Guys and girls, this is a primary example of nitpicking in the fitness industry and taking some super small details and making them way more complicated than they need to be just to sell you a product. Keep in mind, the company making this video has a product to sell you, and that's totally okay. But if you're going to misinterpret information like thermodynamics and calories and saying that hormones play a bigger role than energy balance, well, you're just dead wrong. Hope you have a great day. We'll see you later.